gonna die, and that it was all my fault. I knew her heart wasn't in the best of shape because of her weight, and the doctor had warned us, and she hated flying, but I thought being up there would comfort her soul and bring a smile to her face. But it was only weeks ago that she received the devastating news that the aneurysm on her aorta had grown in size. Any more, her cardiologist said, and she would need dangerous open-heart surgery. But if she could lose at least 50 pounds, that would help prevent her artery from splitting in two. You see, this wasn't the first time Cindy was told to lose weight, and it's not like she wasn't trying to lose weight either. But every failed diet, every gym membership, exercise class, and detox cleanse would convince her that it would never happen, and that she was destined to be overweight, unattractive, and according to her, a lonely old woman whose husband no longer found her sexy, which crushed my soul because it wasn't true. I promise to be there for her through thick and thin, sickness and in health, and I still loved her as much as I did the first night that we met. And still, after 29 years, I made sure to be